my friend loaned me The Rise and Fall of the Third Reich at around about Christmas time last year, I think it was. I started reading it in January of this year, and I'm pleased to report that I have finally finished it. It is 1,249 pages long, with the narrative part being 1,147 pages long. The rest of it is references. Despite the epic size and the epic subject matter, I really, really enjoyed this book. William L. Shirer, the author, is 100% a details man. In fact, there's parts of this book, like, for example, when the declarations of war were taking place, where the narrative goes down to an almost minute-by-minute breakdown of how things were panning out at the time. Shirer's information comes from a number of different sources. These are, for example, notes, diaries, official documents, the Nuremberg trials, things like that. So there's some real meat on the information, and the narrative is brought to life, as it was, because a lot of this is taken from personal accounts. So it feels very real as you're reading through it. The first part of the book, which covers the early years of Hitler and his rise to power and his takeover of government, was the part of the book that probably dragged the most for me. Where it really picked up and really started to grab my interest was once the war got underway. This is where the book became a real page turner for me. Yes, a 1,000 plus page book can indeed be a page turner. And Shirer does a really good job of making things interesting and keeping things moving along at a good pace. In a book this long, it would be very, very easy to get bogged down in too much detail, but he does a really good job of moving things along. This was one of the three things that really stood out to me from this book. The fact that Shirer could really adeptly manage so much information. For example, he would start off, say, on the Western Front, talking about the Russian advance. He'd bring you up to date, bring the narrative along to a particular point, and then he'd switch over to the Eastern Front, where the Allies were coming. And he did a really good job of balancing that information as it all unfolded. He never dwelled on one area for too long, and it never got too boring. He kept things switched up and changing regularly to keep you interested. The other two areas that really stuck out for me were two more sort of personal parts of the story. The second one that is in my mind is, I just want to get his name right, Klaus von Stauffenberg, who was at the forefront of one of the assassination attempts on Hitler. If you've seen the movie Valkyrie, this is the story of those events. Having been familiar with the movie Valkyrie, I was able to have sort of a bird's eye overview of what those events were. But the way that Shirer lays everything out in this book made that part of the book almost like a thriller novel to read, because he's drawn from personal accounts, official documents, etc. This part of the book really comes alive as you realize all of the work and effort and time that went into this very, very dangerous mission to try and end the war early by assassinating Hitler. Absolutely fascinating stuff. And the other thing that I enjoyed was more towards the end of the book, again, taken from personal accounts, diaries, official documents, the Nuremberg trials, things like that, was we could see here the downfall of Hitler, his deterioration of his mental state, the growing lack of trust between his generals and him, just the falling apart of the nation and the absolute failure of his mission. Again, it was really brought to life. You could really feel the darkness and the weight of the situation in that final part of the book. I thought that was really, really well done. As I said, this is all stitched together from diaries, notes, official documents, the Nuremberg trials. And as such, it is a thorough tracking of events of the war from start to finish. It's probably one of the best history books that I've read. So if you've got 9 months or so and you have an interest in history, then I highly recommend and suggest that you check this out.